Good morning, Vandan. Today we are going to discuss briefly about regularization techniques. Before going to regularization technique, let us have a look into bias variance trade-off. If you look into this regression problem, it's a regression problem. This row corresponds to regression. And this is the data we are having, training data we are having. This blue color dots corresponds to training data. And this is our model. Our model here is linear model. We want to represent this data with the help of a linear model. For example, this y coordinate corresponds to y and x coordinate corresponds to x. Then our model is y equals to w1x plus w0. Y equals to w1x plus w0. This is our model. Now with the help of these training samples, we will try to learn those parameters w1 and w0. For that, we will make use of mean square error loss function, mean square error loss function, followed by gradient descent algorithm. With the help of gradient descent algorithm, we will try to minimize that mean square error. And finally, we will end up with some line equation as follows. Some y equals w1x plus w0. We will try to get some w1 value, some w0 value after training. This is what we got finally after training process. Now you can see that this line can't model this data perfectly, right? There's so much error. With the help of a line, you can't model this because this looks like a non-linear function. Second order function might fit well to this data, second order function. For example, y equals w1x w2x square plus w0. This might fit well to this particular data. It's not fitting well. This is the case where our model is second order model. That output y equals to w1x plus w2x square plus w0. And with the help of this training data, we will try to find a mean square error with this model prediction. After that, we will try to apply gradient descent algorithm in order to find the best possible weights w0, w1 and w2. And the final weight, with the help of final weights, we are trying to plot this block curve. This is the curve finally we got after training with that second order model. This looks somewhat good, right? This model looks somewhat good because this black color line, this prediction, black color line corresponds to prediction that y hat equals to w0 plus w1x plus w2x square. After training your weights w0, w1, w2, you will get some values for w0, w1, w2. With the help of that, we got this line, this curve. This looks somewhat suitable for this data, right? Now, when you look into this one, here we are trying to have a very higher order model. Instead of having second order model, here we are fixing our model like y equals to w0 plus w1x plus w2x square plus and so on up to w10x power 10, for example. Our model is having total 11 parameters, including bias w0. We are going up to w10 into x power 10, right? Our parameters are w0, w1, up to w10. These 11 parameters we need to learn with the help of gradient descent algorithm and this training data. Once you learn that one, we are going to get this kind of complex curve. Little bit complex, right? Is it trying to trace almost all the training samples, right? It's trying to pass through almost all training samples after training. Is it trying to overfit our training data? It's trying to overfit our training data. This is looking like a perfect fit and this is underfitting. It's not fitting this data well, right? It's like underfitting. This is like perfect fit or just right fit. This is just like overfitting. Overfitting is nothing but trying to by heart your training samples as it is. That's what this is doing. For example, some noise is there in your training data, then this model will try to track noise also along with your signal. That's a problem with this highly complex models, or when you are having so many parameters, that's a problem you are going to get. That is simply try to by heart your training data. Even though there is a noise, that will try to by heart along with noise also. Generalization capability is a bit low for that one, when that is overfitting your data. That's a problem you are going to get with this. And when coming to this one, when that model is underfitting your data, then you are going to see as follows. You are going to get high training error. You can see this line is not fitting this data very well, right? Your training data also unable to fit properly with the help of this model. It means you are going to get high training error, and test error also will be high, right? Because see, your training error itself is so high, means you can't expect to have less test error. Your test error also you are going to get as very high, and that's almost same as your training error. Now in this just right fit case, training error and test error are almost nearby each other, and the error you are going to get is not so high. This is somewhat reasonable. Bit low, you can say that's somewhat low error you are going to get, training error and test error. And when coming to overfitting, this is simply trying to by heart your training data, even though that's having some amount of noise, right? So the training error for this one is very, very low as compared to underfitting and as compared to just right fit also. This training error is very, very low. But when coming to test error in general much higher as compared to training error. This is a problem you are going to get with this overfitting. It is unable to generalize, right? Good generalization capability means you should try to get less test error, right? During test time, error should be less. But in this overfitting case, during test time you are going to get a bit high error. This is unable to generalize. This is simply by hearting your training data. And when coming to bias and variance, this less complex model is having high bias, because this is just biased towards lower order functions, right? Biased towards lower order functions. Even though data is higher order data, you can't fit to that higher order model, right? Because the model assumption you are going to take is lower order model, y equal to just w naught plus w1x. That is unable to fit your data. You are biased towards your lower order model. Here you are going to get high bias and low variance. Here we are going to get low bias but high variance. High variance means, suppose my training data is something different. Let's have an example for that. Suppose this should be my actual model, second order model. And let's say this is my training data. For example, this is my training data and this is my actual model. Because of noise, this might be dividing slightly, like that you can think. Now after training this with the help of a higher order model, like this y coordinate is y equals to double naught plus w1x plus w2x square, this is x, this is y coordinate, plus and so on, plus W10 x power 10. You are trying to learn these 11 parameters with the help of gradient descent algorithm, and finally you are able to by heart all the training examples with the help of high complex model. Like this you are trying to by heart. For example, if your training data is something different, but that's also coming from the same function, but this time your training data is something like this. This is your training data. Then what you are going to get is, after training with the help of this model and gradient descent algorithm with this training data, you are going to end up with overfitting, right? By hearting your training data. You can see that this red color curve and green color curve, both are highly different, right? They are different, they are not same. That means there is some variability, right? If your training data is something different, then this is changing a lot, right? Your training data is coming from the same function, but some other points from your data set. Then you can see the model you are going to get is much different from your past model. This variability is there, right? This is called a high variance. High variance. It means with overfitting models, you are going to get high variance, right? And one more thing, if you go with just fit model, just fit model means, for example, this is your actual model and your training samples are given by, these are your training samples. Then after training this with the help of less complex model or moderate complex model, W0 plus W1x plus W2x square, you may end up with this kind of model after training. Now suppose you have sampled this function in different points, at different points, some other points, and due to some noise there might be some fluctuation. And if you got this kind of data, if you try to train this one with the help of this model and gradient descent algorithm with this training data, then you might end up with some curve like this. It's almost trying to follow this blue color line, right? Here you are going to get low variance. Here we are going to get low variance when that is right fit case. When that is overfitting case, you are going to get high variance but low bias. When coming to classification task, this red color thing corresponds to class 2, blue color corresponds to class 1. Suppose our classification model is a linear decision boundary with the help of a perceptron. For example, let's say our model in this case is, we have two features, x1 and x2, two features. This one corresponds to W1 x1 plus W2 x2 plus W0 equal to 0. W1 x1 plus W2 x2 plus W0 equal to 0. X1 feature, x2 feature. This is a decision bound you are going to get after learning with the help of perceptron learning algorithm. We are going to end up with some weights W0, W1, W2, some values. After assigning those values, after training, we are going to get this kind of black color line. Now you can see that some of the blue color points are this side, right? Some of the red color points are this side. This is not classifying your data perfectly. Then try to increase the complexity of your model. Instead of having your model like W0 plus W1X1 plus W2X2, try to go for second order model. Something like W0 plus W1X1 plus W2X2 plus W3X1 square plus W4X2 square plus W5 into X1X2. Here we are going to have 6 parameters. Here we are having 1-3 parameters to learn. Here we are having 6 parameters to learn. With the help of learning algorithm, try to learn those parameters, 6 parameters, and after learning those parameters, you are going to end up with this kind of curve. This looks good as compared to this one, right? See, far better compared to this one. Because almost most of the blue color points are this side and red color points are this side, right? This is class 2, this is class 1. Blue color is class 1. Very few samples are misclassified, right? After training. Now, when coming to this model, here we are going up to, for example, 10th order. 10th order means W0 plus W1 X1 plus W2 X2 plus W3 X1 square plus W4 X2 square plus and so on. You will try to go up to X1 power 10, X2 power 10 and multiples X1 power 8 into X2 power 2 like that. You will go up to 10th order polynomial. This is 10th order polynomial boundary. Once you train with that model, with the help of this training data and using some learning algorithm, then you are going to end up with this kind of complex boundary. Looks so complex, right? Very higher order boundary. Here you are able to perfectly separate this class 2 samples from class 1 samples, right? You got almost zero training error. In this case, you are not getting zero training error when that is perfect fit. You got some small training error. Here you got little bit high training error. Here you got almost zero training error. Because all blue samples are this side, all red samples are this side. But the issue here is, this can't generalize your data perfectly when coming to test time. Test time means some unknown sample is given to you. And if I ask you to classify that one, there is a high chance that they can misclassify this, that new sample. The reason for that one is, this training sample, this red colored sample, you can see. If you try to apply your intuition, in general, this should be class 1, right? This should not be class 2. This should not belong to red colored one. This should belong to class 1. Class 1 means blue colored region. Due to noise in your label, training label, instead of showing it like blue, that is showing it like red. There might be noise during labeling, right? Instead of class 1, I might have labeled that one like class 2 while correcting my data set. Due to noise, this might happen, right? Same thing for this also. Actually, this might be red one. Due to noise, that might be treated as blue one. That means your complex model, highly complex model, will try to track noise also, right? That's the problem we are going to get with this. This is overfitting. Trying to by heart your training set. Even you are having some noise in your training set, that will try to by heart along with noise. If there's by hearting along with noise, definitely that won't have the generalization capability, right? That can't generalize to unseen data. That's not so easy, right? That's a problem we are going to get with this one. And just look into this figure. This x coordinate corresponds to number of iterations. For example, if you consider the gradient descent algorithm during learning process, you will try to go in a for loop, right? You will try to do several iterations till you reach up to reasonable quality or reasonable level for your test error, right? The test error should be reasonably lower. Up to that point, you will try to train, right? There will be so many iterations. This corresponds to that epochs or iterations. As you keep on increasing the iterations, what's happening with this less complex model is your training error keeps on decreasing, and after some time your training error is almost constant after some iterations. Similarly, your validation error or test error also keeps on decreasing, and after some iterations of your learning algorithm is almost stabilized, right? And both are almost nearby each other. Training error and validation error or test error, both are nearby each other. And hey, the training error and validation error both are high, right? This value is very high. This is zero. This is far above from zero, right? This error. And when coming to right fit model, you can try to see this one. Training error and validation error both are decreasing as the number of iterations are increasing, and they are almost getting stabilized after so many iterations. These two, this is almost constant. But when compared to this one, this training error is much lower and validation error also much lower compared to this one, and these two are almost nearer. When coming to overfitting models, this training error keeps on decreasing, and finally this almost becoming like zero after some number of iterations. But your validation error is much higher compared to your training error. It's very, very high, right? It's test error or validation error. Because this is just trying to by heart your training data so that your training error is zero. But when coming to generalization, some unknown data is given or some new test data is given to that one, that will try to fail. That won't get success. That will give like an error. So validation error is so high, right? This is a problem of overfitting. So we need to maintain just right fit models. We should not go for very high complex models, or we should not go for very low complex model. There should be some trade-off between bias and variance, right? This is high bias, this is high variance. There should not be so much high bias, there should not be so much high variance in our model. There should be trade-off between both. Here bias and variance are little bit moderate. No one is high in this case, neither bias nor variance. And possible remedies to avoid underfitting are as follows. Either we should try to increase the complexity of the model. For example, this is W0x plus W1x, y equals to. Instead of that, we can try to go for second order. You can try to add one more term plus W2x square and try to learn these three parameters, W0, W1 and W2. This is one remedy. And one more thing is, if you want, you can try to add extra features. Sometimes just one feature may not be enough to predict your output. Then you need to go for one more feature. For example, you are trying to buy an apartment or trying to buy a flat. Then if I try to give the length of that flat, that itself is not enough for cost prediction, right? You should know area. If you want to know the area, you should know that width also, length into width. If you know that area, then you can estimate that well, right? It means you may need to go for extra features. If you are having extra feature with you, then you can predict the data very well, right? Predict the output very well. Or one more thing is, you can train it for longer duration. Here are possible remedies. This may not work all the time. each one of them will work in different situations. You can't expect that all of these will work every time. Sometimes you may need to do all the three together. And when coming to overfitting, this overfitting can be avoided as follows. One way, you can try to collect as much data as you can. Try to increase the number of training samples. For example, if you are having 10,000 training samples now, try to make it like 10 power 6 training samples and like that. If you try to collect more number of training samples, on an average, the noise might be negligible. The effect of noise, that we can see later. You can increase the training data or you can perform regularization. We are going to look into regularization techniques now. Let's have a look into this figure. This is a model complexity versus performance error, prediction error. It's a prediction error. Model complexity means the number of parameters in your model. For example, if I consider some regression model like y equals to w0 plus w1x plus w2x squared. In this case, complexity of my model is 3. I have 3 parameters to learn, right? Like that, you can imagine. This model complexity, this x coordinate corresponds to the number of parameters. More number of parameters this side, less number of parameters this side. Like that, you can think. And this is the prediction error, y coordinate. Now when I look into this one, it's a training error. This curve corresponds to training error. As the model complexity keeps on increasing, you can see the training error also keeps on decreasing, right? When this is increasing, this is decreasing. The reason is just trying to just by heart your training data. Just trying to memorize that one along with noise. If noise also there, they'll try to by heart along with noise. But when coming to test error or validation error, what's happening is, as the model complexity keeps on increasing, this test error keeps on decreasing up to some point, up to some complexity. After that keeps on increasing, right? The reason for this one is, in this region, that is underfitting. In this region, that is overfitting your data. That's why you are unable to do well while generalization. And at this point, that is perfect fit. This almost like perfect fit, this kind of model. This underfitting is also called as high bias, low variance. This overfit also can be represented as low bias and high variance to that model. It's a perfect fit, this point, at this region. Regularization technique to avoid overfitting the data. In general, for most of the practical applications, we don't know what can be the suitable model complexity in advance. So in general, we'll start with little bit complex model than what we guess, and we'll train the model with regularization. Regularization technique will try to add some penalty for weights during minimization of loss function to avoid overfitting. This leads to nullifying the unwanted higher order terms in our model. For example, consider linear regression problem as follows. Let's consider this as a kth training sample. X bar k, kth training sample, this is an input feature vector, and this is the output we are going to expect, yk. Output of kth training example is the input of that kth training example. Let's assume that this is d cross 1 dimension, x1k, x2k, up to xdk. Let's assume that we have n such training samples and our prediction model is linear in this case. Y hat equals to W transpose X. It means that y hat equals to w1 x1 plus w2 x2 plus and so on, wd xd, linear model. Instead of having only squared error as the loss function, we'll also have some penalty term to the weights. You can try to see this. Earlier, in order to apply gradient descent algorithm, what we had done is we considered this training loss function 1 by 2 into sigma k equals to 1 to n yk minus w transpose x bar whole square. We considered up to this loss function and we tried to minimize this loss function with the help of gradient descent algorithm. That's what we had done earlier. Now what we are doing is we are trying to add this penalty term to the weights also. We are trying to add some extra penalty term for this one, some penalty for weights, where lambda is some positive quantity. If I consider lambda to be very high positive value, then I am trying to say that I am adding more penalty for weights. If lambda is somewhat less positive quantity, then I am trying to add less penalty for the weights. Like that you can think. Lambda equal to 0 means no penalty for the weights at all. Where this corresponds to L cube norm. Norm Q whole power Q equals to mod W1 power Q plus and so on mod W D power Q. If Q equal to 1, then it is L1 norm regularization. If Q equal to 2, then it is L2 norm regularization. Because this is L1 norm, right? Q equal to 1 means when Q equal to 2, this corresponds to L2 norm. What H value we are doing here is for example in our case just second order model is enough, right? But what H value we are doing in this slide is we are not going with second order model, we are going with for example very higher order model, 10th order model, W0 plus W1x plus W2 x squared plus and so on plus W10 x410. We are going for a very higher order model. And what we are doing is, this is a prediction from our model y hat. We are trying to predict with the help of given x value. So y hat is our prediction. What we are trying to do here is, we are trying to minimize this. This is actual y value and this is a predicted y value. This is y hat. Y minus y hat whole square. I am replacing y hat with this one. W naught plus sigma w I x power I equals to 1 to 10. And overall training examples. Overall training examples means this should be kth training example, k equals to 1 to n, overall training examples, right? This is the last for that one. See for kth training example. Okay, in this example, d equal to 1. We have actually x bar equals to x1, x bar d cross 1 dimension, right? D equal to 1. It means x bar is nothing but x in our example. This is just a regression problem. X bar equal to x, d equal to 1. Here the dimension is 1. Just for easy understanding, we are going with one dimension, that input. That's it. Along with this, what we are going to do here is, instead of minimizing just this mean square error or squared error loss, we are trying to minimize along with this lambda some positive constant. If that is L2 regularization, non W2 square. Non W2 square is nothing but this is real, right? It's not complex. So we can go with mod square is nothing but square. W1 square plus and so on plus W10 square. Let's assume like, for example, lambda equals to 2. For example, 2 into something, right? We are trying to minimize this error and this one also, both together, right? Suppose in the process of minimization, let's consider our training data. Due to overfitting, we may get something like this. This may try to by heart the things. Due to overfitting, because we considered higher order model, right? Y equals W0 plus W1 x plus W2 x square plus and so on plus W10 x power 10. Second order means you may get some shape like this. Second order means. But 10th order, due to 10th order, we are getting this kind of sharp transitions. Our target is we need to nullify them. We need to remove these coefficients somehow with the help of regularization, right? That's the reason we are trying to add some penalty for the weights. For this particular model, in general, we are going to get these values to be very, very high. W10, W9, W8 and so on up to W3. These weights will be so high in order to get this kind of complex model. But by adding this penalty term, we are trying to minimize this whole thing together, right? Whole thing together. If lambda equal to 0, then you might end up with this kind of complex model. When lambda is some positive quantity, then what will happen is, as you are going to get larger values for these things, they will try to nullify it, they will try to make it like zeros almost. Then finally, you might end up with this kind of model due to that penalty or due to that regularization. Because this is becoming higher, right? When you are going to have this kind of model with training, you are going to get large values for these weights. Those will get a penalty from this one. Then this total sum is increasing, right? When you are getting W10 to be so high, then this sum is increasing because plus W10 square into 2 is part of this, right? Then what your gradient descent algorithm will do is, they will try to nullify the W10. They will try to make it like almost 0. That's what that is going to do. That reverse effect will happen due to that penalty. And finally, you may end up with this kind of curve. Due to regularization, you may get almost like perfect fit model, right? That's the beauty of regularization. Thank you.